Now we have Sarah Moore from the Department of Marketing, Business, Economics, and Law in the School of Business to address the question of whether the number of guests at the wedding indicates love or divorce.
So first, thank you for the invitation. Second, I want to start with a couple of questions. Number one, how much did you spend on your wedding? And number two, how many people were there? So keep that in mind while I show you this first number. The current average cost of a wedding is $33,000. That's over half the median income in the US. 80% of that cost is driven by the number of people that you invite to the wedding. So on average, we have about 136 people at our weddings. About 60% of weddings have between 50 and 150 guests. But despite all of that money and all of those witnesses, the divorce rate is still about 50%. So it's important to understand that number because, generally speaking, divorce is bad for your health and well-being, and happy marriage is good for your health and well-being. So there's been lots of research that looks at factors that predict marital outcomes. So things like religiosity and having a child with your partner, those are protective factors. They decrease your likelihood of divorce. But not very much research has looked at factors related to the wedding itself and how those might predict marital outcomes. So that's what we looked at. So we did a bunch of surveys, some on divorced individuals, some on married individuals. For all of the surveys, we asked people, how many guests did you invite to your wedding ceremony? How many people were there? For the divorced samples, we asked, how long did your marriage last? For the married samples, we asked, how positive, loving, caring, and happy do you currently feel towards your spouse? And we measured a whole bunch of control variables like religiosity and children, if you had a prenup, to see if wedding guest number would predict over and above those other variables. So we find the same pattern across different samples. So for both the divorced and the married samples, if you had a medium number of wedding guests, you had the least positive feelings toward your spouse and the shortest marriages. You had worse marital outcomes than people who had fewer guests or people who had more guests. So I want to stress that this is not a causal relationship. This does not mean that if you change the number of guests at your wedding, it will predict divorce. But it does mean that wedding guest number is capturing something unique. It's indicating or representing something. So to find out what, we did a final survey. We surveyed engaged individuals. We asked, how many people are you going to invite to your wedding? And we measured a whole bunch of other variables that might predict wedding guest number. So we found that things like difficulty generating your guest list increased the number of people you were planning to invite, and things like financial stress decreased the number of guests you were planning to invite. So what does that mean? That wedding guest number itself is a complex variable that's predicted by lots of things. So I can't tell you if you invited the right number of people to your wedding, can't tell me how many people you should invite to your wedding. The best advice I can give you is use wedding guest number as an indicator. If you find that these variables are leading you to invite a middling number of guests to your wedding, think very carefully about how you got there and maybe get some counseling.